Kanye West Donda is still not here. It's been 2 release dates, 4 listening parties, and at this point, the sentiment around the whole community and the Kanye fan base from what we're seeing is that the hype is dying down, and it's because there's been all of these teases of the music and there's been a lot of headlines, but at the end of the day, the body of work is just not there.
And we did a video on this on Friday where we had talked about, you know, like what we had thought about the whole situation, you know, will it ever drop? And it's crazy because for the first time in a really long time, I see Kanye fans getting upset at this whole rollout, being like, yo, listen, you know, I'm in that same boat. Like, I've just lost interest in this whole rollout. Like, I'll be here when the album drops. But nonetheless, like, I'm not even down for a second party. A fifth party, including the Las Vegas one. So I agree. Like, we had given our takes on it. We had said what we had said. And we, you know, we're in this boat now where I don't even want another listening party. Like, I already know what the album sounds like, and I'm going to sound like a broken record, but we need the record. So, at the end of the day, do you think that we're in the right spot? And what could he really do to revive the hype again? Because the sentiment in the community is dying down. People are gravitating more towards CLB and Kendrick's album now because those announcements have come. And
yeah,
I don't really know where it's at
anymore. We're in the midst of these 3 rollouts, guys. And if you want to stay updated with everything related to these 3 album drops, turn on your notifications and stay tuned and subscribe if you're new here, because we're covering the biggest hip-hop releases and we'll be taking you guys through everything that happens, you know, with this Donda journey, everything that's kind of notable, I would say. And smash the like button because it helps this video get to other Kanye fans and other music fans in general. But in terms of what he has to do to actually get that hype going again is to announce that he's dropping on September 3rd alongside Drake, because that's been a huge narrative since this Donda rollout began, is the fact that we might have the biggest sales battle and just head-to-head album battle in general since what he did with 50 Cent in 2007, where Graduation went head-to-head with Curtis. And we saw, I believe, Kanye's highest first week sales. I think he did over 900,000 copies first week. So the only way for Kanye to kind of reinstill that sentiment of excitement would be to drop alongside Drake. So do you agree with that?
I do agree with that, but I think it's also a product of other things. I think people are just getting too used to the material now. Like, a lot of people were super disappointed with how the third listening party sounded. I'm talking about the music that was showcased in Chicago. So people were disappointed by that. People were disappointed by the fact that a lot of parts were cut from that listening party, and people now are skeptical of the actual album itself. Not only that, but looking at the listening parties, people are kind of, you know, getting used to it. You know, there's no more elements of surprises with these listening parties. It feels the same with, you know, besides the sets changing and the aesthetics changing, the sentiment around them are the same. You know, people are going into them, they'll listen to the album and be like, oh, okay, I didn't get the album.
Except that the favorite parts from the other listening party, which is, you know, the second one in Atlanta, were removed. I mean, you had the amazing Jay-Z verse and the Return of the Throne just completely scrapped off and replaced for a whack the baby verse, to be honest. And apart from that, I mean, you also got Kid Cudi's verses taken away. The Pusha T song was not there for that listening party. And I hate to say it, because Kanye is such an innovator, and what he's done with this rollout before this listening party was genius to me, because no other artist has previewed music and showcased it on as big of a scale as this. But to me, at this point, I mean, after bringing out those controversial figures, after doing the whole wedding ceremony with Kim Kardashian, I feel like he's gravitating towards the headlines and not the art within the music. And that's what kind of frustrates me as a Kanye fan. And at this point, I mean, I've lost all interest. If this album comes, it fucking comes. If it doesn't, I don't care anymore, because Drake's dropping. You know what I mean? Because Kendrick's on the way. So there's no real excitement left in me. I do love a lot of the music that was previewed at the first and second listening parties, but I just don't give a fuck anymore, man. I'll be straight up about it.
Yeah, there's no more excitement left in this whole rollout, because you already know the album. You know, it hasn't dropped yet, but everything's sounding, you know, it's kind of like you're going into a direction. You know what the album's going to sound like, and if you're already getting a tour before the album drops, What happens when the album drops? How are people going to receive this? How are people going to age with this? How are people going to sit with this? You know, Kendrick's delivering some of the best material of his life on fucking feature runs. Drake has just announced that he's dropping CLB in such a cool way with, you know, the whole ESPN glitch. Like, there's people right now that I feel as if are rolling out their albums better. And it's not to say that this whole, like, you know, listening party thing was not a success, because if he would have dropped it after the second one, okay. That would have been fucking massive. But yo, we're at the third listening party where it was streamed, where people had access to the music, where people were listening to it, where people, you know, had made their narratives, and you're still not delivering it.
Like, I have a question for you, man. Yeah. Let me ask you this. If the album let's say he took exactly what we heard from the listening party in Chicago and put that out as the album, would you have rather have gotten that as an album or get nothing at all?
Get no nothing project. At all.
I agree.
Abs, come on.
I agree, stop, man. That, like, that would have put, to me, a dent in Kanye's overall discography, man.
There was,
it really would
there,
have.
There was a...
I hate to say it, though, because I'm a huge Kanye fan. Sucks. And I think that he has one of the best catalogs of all time, man. To me, his first six albums are all classics. And at this point, there is a lot of good from what we heard in the last two listening parties, not counting the Chicago one. So hopefully he makes some more changes. Hopefully he adds back the features that people loved. And hopefully the whole concept of him finding closure, spiritually with his mother Donda, can really take flight and really be the focus of the project. But at this point, like I said, I'll listen when it comes, and I hope that I'll love it. But I've lost interest, man. That's what it is. That's the bottom line.
I don't know. I feel as if I get bamboozled, like, all the time. Like, I feel as if it's one big fucking joke, like, being played on me every single time I'm going into these albums. Like, okay, I get it. You did it a couple of times, and you'll keep doing it to me. I get it. But, bro, like, you know, the fans matter. The fans matter in this whole fucking experience. That's what I feel as if frustrates me the most, is that everything as far as, you know, the cinematic value of things, you know, having, you know, showcasing the music, doing all this shit, like, it's fucking great. It's entertaining. But there's one really important key part that's missing in all of this. Consideration for the fucking fans. Like, that's where I feel as if this whole rollout is lacking. Is just like, where do we get to eat? Like, I understand, like, you want to hype us up, but, you know, you're just like, you're throwing a bunch of smoking mirrors in front of us until, like, I say, fuck it. Like, I'm not trying to get hyped for this album anymore. And I think, like, I'm slowly getting there. I don't think I'm fully there yet. I'm still going in with high hopes for the album, and I still want to hear the final version of it, but I'm really losing interest.
I definitely feel you. Do you feel like if he does drop next Friday on September 3rd that this whole thing was him truly waiting for Drake's release date? Like, do you think that would confirm it? I think so.
Yeah, sure. But even at that,
still, like, sounds finished.
Yeah, but what is that going to do for his fucking album? It doesn't make it any better for me. It doesn't make this whole experience better for me.
It'll make it a moment, though.
It'll make it, okay, for Drake. I'll still take it for Drake.
I don't know.
Come on. Because the thing is that you have to understand something. Like, it's going to bring, like, hype to Kanye's album, but
it won't make the music better.
It won't make the music better, but there's also Drake a part of that equation. So imagine what that does for Drake. Like, Drake is a part of that equation. I think that's where everyone's sleeping now. It's like, yes, Kanye's going to be riding that hype. Yes, Kanye has a stacked feature list. But we're talking about Drake, dude. Like, this guy hasn't sold under 500,000 in nearly a decade.
Well, I think it's more about the conversation who's going to drop the better album. So, I mean, we'll have to see.
But the thing is that people will be jaded by the fact of that first week sales battle. Like what happened with Graduation and Curtis.
Yeah,
people were, yes, talking about the music, and the music lived on, and we saw what had better replay value over the years. But we all remember one fact. Graduation outsold Curtis.
Yes,
and that's going to be that same subject for this one.
But I would say that, like, the fact that not only did it outsell it, but it also was the better album, truly made it one massive W for Kanye and Graduation in that sense. So it'll be cool to see if it does go down, who will obviously sell more, which I think it's obvious that it's Drake, but to see also who has the better album. And I do hope that if this does come out, that it's reworked and that the best moments from the parties are showcased on the project, because I want another Kanye classic. I really do.
As a Kanye fan, I want to hear another album that's going to stick through my rotation for the next 15 years of my life. That's what I want. I want to be able to celebrate Kanye's beautiful music and really get his best material that he's delivered in years. But at the end of the day, if he's not doing it, then, you know, it's just wishful thinking at a certain point. But guys, on a positive note, NFR will be keeping you updated throughout this whole Donda experience. We thought we'd make this video because there's a lot of comments and there's a lot of reception around this Kanye album that's kind of shifting at the moment. So I hope you guys enjoyed this type of video. As I said, we're keeping you updated throughout all of the biggest rollouts this summer and for the rest of the year. So subscribe if you have not already. Hit the like button if you like this video, and we'll catch you in the next one. Thank you for watching the video. It's always a pleasure doing content for you guys. Listen, if you haven't already, subscribed to the channel because we're doing album reviews, and we actually have our series called Everything We Know, where we take you guys through the whole album rollout of the hottest releases of the year. Not only that, guys, but our Patreon plan is now live. You guys could access that in the bio. I appreciate you guys, and I'll see you on the next one.